بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. They say mankind, men, people by nature are forgetful. And for that reason, some of the scholars devote to say the word insan, which translates to be man or mankind, is derived from the same word as forgetfulness, an-nisyan. So mankind, by nature, we forget, and we need reminders. We need to be told over and over again, so that we don't forget, we take action, we understand and we keep in front of us what really matters. So Allah the Almighty, He says in the Quran, سَنُرِيهِمْ آيَاتِنَا فِي الْآفَاقِ وَفِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَتَّى يَتَبَيَّنَ لَكُمْ أَنَّهُ الْحَقِّ. That soon we shall show them signs. We will show them signs, our signs. Where? In the horizon, in the universe, in the things happening around them. وَفِي أَنفُسِهِمْ and within yourselves, until the truth becomes apparent and clear for them. Now we've seen ourselves, and this is a continuation from the discussion of last khutbah. So the Imam last week, he spoke about the virtues of Friday and what we've been missing out on. Now let's understand why we missed out on these things. Why is it that Allah took away this opportunity from us for the last 4 months, and only up until recently that we've been given this opportunity to come back and visit the house of Allah? Why is it that Allah has made us a guest in our house only after 4 months? Why? We look around us and we see the signs. What did Allah do? He sent down an illness which was blind to our eyes. We couldn't see it. We didn't know it was there. We can't physically touch it. We can't smell it. We can't taste it. Yet we know it's there and it's causing effect. It's having some sort of effect on us. It's impacted every single one of our lives. And Allah is telling us, we shall show you our signs in the afaq, in the horizons, in the world around you, in your environment. And we've seen it. And within yourselves there are signs. We see some people are able to fight off this disease without any problem. They go to get themselves checked out and the test comes back positive, but there's no symptoms. Whilst others who are fit and healthy, who have no underlying conditions at all whatsoever, are affected by this illness. So Allah is showing us another sign within ourselves. Until the truth becomes apparent to us. We know by looking at these signs, what Allah is telling us is the truth, what the Quran is telling us is the truth, what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has prophesied and told us before he had left is the truth. Now why does this happen? Why is it that we have to go through this test? It's unheard of at these times. You know, me and my friend were making a joke the other day. You know, when we open up the books of Seerah, and you look at when the Prophet ﷺ was born. And at that time, there was no formal calendar system in place. So they would say he was born in the year of the elephant. Amul Fil. When did the Isra take place and Mi'raj? They say Amul Huzn, the year of grief. Because there's no formal calendar in place, they would use different incidents to pinpoint as to when this certain thing happened. And it's going to become such a thing now. That when we look into their future, we're going to look back and say, this is the year of Corona. SubhanAllah. It's going to leave a mark on our calendars. So Allah the Almighty, He then says in another place in the Quran, why did Allah put us through this? Why did Allah put us through this? We need to understand, we need to reflect, we need to make a change. He says, ظَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِ النَّاسِ لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. Let's understand what Allah is telling us in this verse. He says that fasad has become apparent. It's come out. It has shown us its head. Where? In the land and the sea. What is fasad? Normally we would translate it to be mischief. Somebody was causing trouble, problems. But here, the scholars, they would explain, it does not mean somebody's going around causing problems. It means disruption, interruption is happening on the earth, it's happening on the seas. Why? Because of what the hands have committed. ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس. Because of the deeds of the people living on the earth. And then you open up the books of tafsir and you go and you check it out and you read and try to understand what is Allah saying. The scholars, they all unanimously, they all say, it's due to the sins of mankind that things are put into interruption and, you know, everything is out of place and chaos starts to happen throughout the world. And when you open up the books of tafsir, subhanAllah, they mention, you know, you open up tafsir Ruh al-Ma'ani of Allama al-Alusi, or you open up Madarik al-Tanzil of Imam al-Nasafi, and the first thing that they mention, or amongst the first thing that they mention, is that due to the actions and the sins of the people, Allah sends down pandemics, which will take away the lives of mankind, which will cause a shortage of food and provision. Did we not see, subhanAllah, we just look back 3-4 months. We look back 3-4 months. And there was this rush, and there was this chaos over simple things like toilet tissue, subhanAllah. We've seen it. How true are the words of Allah? How true are the explanations of the scholars? The first thing they mention in the tafsir is that our deeds, our sins, our violation of the laws of Allah, the Almighty, causes a pandemic to come, causes illness to come throughout the world. SubhanAllah. And this is what has caused all this to happen. لِيُذِيقَ مِن بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. So that you may be able to taste only a portion of what you have done. This is only a portion of the punishment for our sins. Only a portion. لَعَلَّكُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. So that you may observe this, you may see this, understand this, reflect on this, and then turn back to Allah. Turn back to Allah. If we, after witnessing all this, we see no positive changes in our life, we see nothing has changed at all, we continue to sin and we continue to disregard the laws of Allah, the Almighty, and the teachings of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then when is the time for change? When is the time for change? I put out the hadith in front of you, inshallah, and with that we will conclude. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he addressing his companions, he calls out to them and he says, kullu ummati mu'afan illa al-mujahirun wa illa al-mujahirin. Kullu ummati mu'afan illa al-mujahirin. That my entire ummah is entitled to forgiveness. My entire ummah is entitled to forgiveness. When we stand in the court of Allah, we are standing for judgment, and our books are being opened up so that Allah may judge us for our deeds. We are all entitled to forgiveness. Allah may forgive us as He wills. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he makes one exception, and he says, "Illa al-mujahideen." And no, I'm not saying "illa al-mujahideen," not the warriors of Allah. "Illa al-mujahideen with the Rab." So the companions sitting around, they ask, O Messenger of Allah, who are the Mujahideen? Who are these people, the Mujahideen? So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, answering their query, he says, it is that person or those people who commit sin by night. They are doing their deeds, they're doing whatever they feel like. And we know that in the darkness of the night, when no one else is watching, we might be sinning. Whether it might be in a haram relationship, taking pills, drug dealing, whatever it might be. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this person is committing his sin during the night. And then as soon as day breaks, and Allah has allowed him to wake up and spend the morning in such a situation where Allah has hidden his sin. Satarahullah. Allah has hidden his sin. It's a sin between himself and Allah. No one else is aware of it. Now this person, he will go out and he says, Ya fulan, amiltu al-barihata kada wa kada. Amiltu al-barihata kada wa kada. You know, last night I did this sin and I did that. Last night I was drug dealing. Last night I went and stole this. Last night I abused this person. Last night I did that and I did this. I did this and I did that. and is coming out and publicizing his sins. This is what I have gone up to. And then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, وَقَدْ بَاتَ يَسْتُرُهُ رَبُّهُ. He spent the night in a situation where Allah had veiled his sin, covered it up from the mankind, from his creation. وَيُصْبِحُ يَكْشِفُ سِتْرَ اللَّهِ عَنْهُ. And come the morning, what does this person do? He removes this cloak and this veil that Allah had put over his sin, and he is publicizing it. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that this person who goes out and he exposes his sins, he publicizes his sins, for that person, there is no forgiveness. Wal-iyadu billah. Now my appeal is to our youth. My appeal is to our users of social media. How many times do we find ourselves that we are documenting our sins? We are taking pictures of our sins. We are putting them on our WhatsApp statuses. We're putting them up on our Instagram stories. We are Snapchatting them. And we are posting them on our Facebook. The scholars, my teachers used to say, when we do such things, it becomes an open challenge of disobedience to Allah. A public challenge of disobedience to Allah. May Allah protect us. How severe our sins are. That not only does it bring about the disruption of the entire universe, entire world, but it becomes a means of our sin, of us not attaining the mercy and the forgiveness of Allah. We need to think before we do. Yes, we've committed a sin. It stays between me and Allah. You know, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said this hadith, he says that the person went out and he spoke to somebody and he told them about it. That person may or may not remember after a while. But when we document it, we want to take a picture of it. When we want to record ourselves doing that sin, wal-iyadu billah, may Allah protect us from it. It's not going away. We need to think about our future. You know, when we go applying for a job and the employer wants to do a simple Google search on the person, these things pop up. It makes it difficult for ourselves in the future. So it's things that we need to think about. A public, you know, declaration of disobedience to Allah when we start documenting our sins. And these are the things which take away the barakah. You know, Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he used to say, ظَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ. What does that mean? Fasad has become exposed, it has come out in the land and the sea. It means that barakah, blessings has been taken away and it's been snatched away from the homes. How many of our homes is deprived of barakah? We don't see no blessings in our home. No salah taking place. There's no obedience from the child to the parent. There's no respect. There's no tilawa, no Quran, no dhikr, no adhkar. Nothing happening. Why? Because all this barakah is being taken away as a result of our sins. So we need to make a positive change. Reflect on ourselves. The way Allah said, سَنُرِيهِمْ آيَاتِنَا فِي الْآفَاقِ وَفِي أَنْفُسِهِمْ. We shall show you signs within the horizon. Our signs within the horizon. In the environment around you and within yourselves, let's reflect over ourselves. Let's think about what I'm doing and what can I do to better myself for the future. What do I need to stop doing so that we don't go back into the situation we were in for the last 4 months? May Allah allow us to really truly understand the message of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, really implement it into our lives, protect us from sinning. And if we do commit a sin, that we only keep it within between ourselves and Allah, and we ask Allah to forgive our sins, and may He make us from amongst those who He has said that they are entitled to His forgiveness. Subhanallah bihamdi, subhanallah bihamdi, mashallah la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruhu wa atubu ilayk. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah lakum wa lisa'iril muslimin, fastaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد عبده ورسوله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وبعد، فقد قال الله تعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون وأقيموا الصلاة